SEC schools really epitomize what a rivalry is all about. We should see plenty of big plays and hard hits today. And now let's head down to the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. McGrath has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's on the run, and he's sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Inside give. Nice run, and he's brought down. The 33-yard line. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
Williams is back deep to return. Williams fields at the 29, and he's tackled at the 39-yard line.
Tillman's a guy that just his freakish ability, you look at him and you go, I can't believe he can do that kind of thing.
Absolutely. I mean, he's a guy that you're looking to isolate against the defense, try to find the one-on-one matchup. You know, the defense today will do everything that they can to try to have two defenders on him the entire game, but eventually they're going to make a mistake, and when they leave him alone, look out. That's when this offense will look to make their big plays.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. And he's knocked out immediately after the catch.
That's the kind of rangy flanker every quarterback wants to be throwing to. He did well to make sure he had enough yardage to pick up the first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 40.
Ready! Blue 45!
Now he tries to buy some time. He's pushed out of bounds at the 24. First and 10, ball on the 24. He's tackled at the 5.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
That'll be a big boost. You always want to capitalize on these short yardage situations, and that pass was an excellent call.
And he tacks on the extra point.
So a 7-play, 61-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
And it was really those long runs that really helped propel that drive.
He just drills this one. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Volunteers are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
They'll go ground. Tackle at the 26. From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. Pass is caught, the defense lays him out. Receivers got the first down. Tackle made around the 41-yard line.
Great job by the quarterback. He had a slant called against zone coverage and threw it at the perfect time.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down around the 42-yard line. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down at the 39. From the 39-yard line, it's first down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Slings it. And they make the stop at about the 39-yard line. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And he's taken down at the 12. This is the eighth play of this drive. Tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Looks to a receiver. Touchdown! He fired it out to his wide receiver, who made the grab and got the score.
When this guy's got time to throw, he makes the defense pay.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
He's tackled around the 28-yard line. It's second and 7. Ball on the 28. He's scrambling. He's to the 40, and down he goes at the 42.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
You know, he's been working really hard lately on his fundamentals. In fact, the other day in practice, I was really watching him work with the quarterback coach, and they've been focusing on that aspect of it. Here, it looked like he may have taken a step backwards and really just let that one go.
They'll get him for a loss. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48.
Come on, baby. Come on. Let's go. Fires the mic. Fires the mic. Ready!
Strike to his receiver. No good. So that'll make it fourth down.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Brooks awaits the snap. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He dropped it.
I'll tell you, a few plays in football can test your concentration like returning punts. You got to see the ball into your hands while not worrying about being hit.
The main thing is they got the ball back, and now they can go to work on offense.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
Finds his receiver who's all alone. And he's tackled right around the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line. First down.
My 10. He can't handle it.
Man wide open, in and out of his hands. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 28. Here's the halfback on the screen. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. They get a 1 yard loss on that one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Coming, and they're going to come after this one. Williams fields it at the 41, and he shoved out of bounds at the 48.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
That quickly incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver and maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Tackle around the 46-yard line.
That's how we do, G. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38.
Very stern effort there by the defense. They weren't giving up anything on that series.
He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. From their own 20-yard line, second down.
Night.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Made around the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line. First down. Now he's scrambling. And they get the sack.
You know, Brad, that time the defense brought the blitz, and I think it confused the offensive line. It's one thing to pick up the blitz. You also have to be accountable for the defensive lineman. And that time the lineman got to the quarterback and came up with a sack.
There's a strike complete. He's taken down at the 33. Third down again. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Well, that's a great job here by the defense to knock that football away and set up a fourth down.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one.
He makes it to the 35-yard line. So at the end of one, we're even at 7 in this one. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Fires out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at about the 49. From the 49-yard line, it's first down. And he's going to be sacked.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
He's at the 40. He's at the 30. To the 20. He goes down at the 14-yard line. First and 10. Let's see if they can build off that great run. He tackles him for a loss.
That's the way to hit. Mike 10. Tight end right.
Ready.
Watch the two. Let's go,
Red.
He fights forward to about the 13. From the 13-yard line, third down.
Tends the mic.
And he's sacked.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Tennessee could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up. Not a lot of success on that kick.
We get a tie game at 7-7. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. The defense scoops it. He really wanted that ball, didn't he, Kurt?
You can't teach hustle like that. The linebacker was determined to get the ball there, and he did.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. They go with the run, and he's taken down behind the line. It's second down now, 13 to go. Ball on the 32. Nice run there. Small picks up about 4 yards on the play.
Roger, Roger. Fires the mic. Fires the mic. Here we go, here we go. Run up.
Stepping up. And they got him.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Tennessee is looking to go up by three. He gets it up, and he got it. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He makes it out to about the 27-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. Makes it to the 37. And the delayed handoff works for a big gain.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
Right, right, Roger, Roger. Four down, here we go. Watch seven. Watch seven.
Watch it. And he's tackled after positive yardage. We've got a second and five. Ball on their own 42. Couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
One thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
Larry, Larry, Larry. Tim's the mic. Tim's the mic. Check the out.
Five wide. He's hit and taken down.
This is a big first down for this offense. I think it's another good example about how important it is to have an awareness about you as a wide receiver. The wide receiver did a really good job of knowing exactly where the first down marker was, and he made sure to get the route at least to that point, so when he made the catch and got hit, he had the first down.
And he is drilled at the 47-yard line. It's second down, seven to go. Ball on the 47-yard line.
Watch the motion.
gains his way to the 36-yard line.
So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Gains his way to the 26-yard line.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They bring their quarterback down.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Mike 10.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
Second down and a ways to go because of the penalty.
Four down. Tends the mic. Tends the floor. Motion. Bump. There you go.
Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. That's a loss of about three.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback.
Tillman's shown that he is a team player, and sometimes that's kind of hard to find with a wide receiver. They tend to have their own agenda sometimes. But even with him struggling today, I'm pretty sure he's happy with how his teammates have picked things up around it.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to talk with him on Thursday getting ready for this game, and that's the one thing that just seemed to come out of him was just how much he cares about the team's success. And here's another example. The team's playing well enough to have the lead here in this first half, and he's not putting up any numbers, and yet he's not hanging his head. He's not worried about his individual stats, and that's always a mark, I think, of an outstanding teammate and a great wide receiver.
Throws incomplete.
He put a little bit too much mustard on that throw, and it got away from him.
From their own 22-yard line, it's third down. Tennessee is up by three. On the ground, up the middle, brought down at the 24-yard line. Kentucky's going to take their first time out of the half. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. And he's hammered down. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. They'll run it. And he's taken down around the 28-yard line. Kentucky will take their second time out of the half. They'll spread the field with five wide.
There you go.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And they make the stop at the 9. And that one's incomplete.
Sometimes when you throw it that hard, you can't control the accuracy all that well. He'll get it under control, though, in time.
It's second and goal. 9 yards to the goal line. And down he goes at the 1. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he hits the PAT. So that's a 6-play, 53-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Volunteers struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how he can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play. One touch could get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 25. So at the end of the half, the Wildcats lead 14-10.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Let's not get too carried away by the numbers, but both of these teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass. It's an indication, it seems, that maybe there's not the personnel out there that really scares this defense, that can really stretch the defense.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time, having those big-time speed guys and those playmakers on the outsides that really make the cornerbacks bail and take away the deep ball. And they're not scared right now. They're just squatting on the outside and saying, you're not going to run by me, you're not going to throw it deep, and all I'm going to do is try to make sure that you catch the underneath stuff and wrap you up and tackle you. So somebody has to emerge as a playmaker, and you have to find the playmakers down the field to make some big home run plays.
That's going to do it at halftime, just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30-yard line. The Wildcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Blue 14! And he just gets rid of it. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line.
They're not ready for this, man.
Ready!
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Throws it, and oh, he dropped it. Robinson is back awaiting the punt. And this one is a beauty. Tackle made at the 36-yard line. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Kentucky holds a 4-point lead. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked. So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
We got tight left, tight left. Pull down, pull down.
Tim's the mic. Tim's the mic.
We got both sides of the floor.
Here we go. Checking motion. Check the
tackle. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 49. They'll knock him down for a loss. Give to the tailback. Tackle at the 44. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Kentucky is up by 4. And he's tackled at the 21.
You're always looking for the home run return. The big highlight didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 21.
Here we go, here we go.
Up the middle for a nice game. Scrambling. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. They'll bring him down around the 31-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. Nice run up the middle. Small picks up about 7 yards on the run. The halfback makes it to the 47.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play action pass.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47. And he's hit before he could go anywhere. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
He's tackled at the 36. And this is the eighth play of the drive. He fights forward to about the 36.
That's the way you fly the ball.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down.
You ain't doing nothing today. Hey, watch that, watch that.
Ready?
He gets hit out of bounds at the 11-yard line. From the 11-yard line, it's first down. Zips it to the tight end. He's taken down at the 10-yard line. This is the 11th play of this drive. And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. Third down again. Here's a throw, and it's almost picked. Kicks away, and he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Kentucky up a point. Feeds it to the back. What a run! Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown, Wildcats. He's carried this offense on his back, that's for sure. He's got 200 yards.
He might get the big numbers in the box score, but this has been a team effort all the way around, and everybody deserves some credit.
And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 27. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. There's a fumble, and the quarterback comes in and scoops up the fumble. Brought down at the 40. That was a huge turnover.
Yeah, and it couldn't have come at a better time for this defense. You're trying to come up with a big stop, and now you get the ball back with the lead.
We see this offense again after what you, Kirk, call a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Just throws this one away. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. Kentucky is up by 8. Runs it, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage. come out in a 5-wide set. Fires it out. Very good tackle in space. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Makes the grab and steps out right away. Fights forward to about the 13. From the 13-yard line. Second down. Now he tries to buy some time. He keeps it. It's away from him. Touchdown. Defense let the quarterback scramble in for the score.
The defense had the offense beat there initially. It took a great run to get that in.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A 6-play, 40-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 28-13. And down he goes at the 30.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. And they get the sack. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Third and long now after the sack.
Hey, watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Fives the mic, fives the mic. Ready, ready. Yeah.
There's a strike complete. And they push him out at around the 48-yard line. So at the end of three, the Wildcats lead 28-13. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Three down. Mike five. Run!
Gives it left side. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Here's an opening. And he's taken down at the 34. Quick throw out to the receiver. Bounces off the would-be tackler. He's pushed out of bounds at the 27-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Off to the left, and they wrestle him down behind the line.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
This is the 8th play of this drive.
Roger, Roger!
going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
What great catch by the wide receiver, and the guy who needs to be thanking him is the quarterback. That's not where he wanted that ball to go, but the receiver made the catch and saved the quarterback for a touchdown.
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He's in for the conversion. McGrath has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
And he got all of this one. Great kick.
He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line.
It's been a fun night for this running back.
He sure is, Brad. I mean, the defense is just having a hard enough time just trying to bring him down.
As much as all the yards help, a trip to the end zone would be huge right now to keep the pressure on their rivals. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way.
Kentucky is up by a touchdown. He scrambled.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation.
Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run.
And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Complete. Tackle made around the 46-yard line.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Throws left. The running back's got it.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Throw to the tight end. And down he goes.
At about the 29-yard line.
First and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Kentucky up 7 points. Got a man. Watch out here. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
They make the stop
right around the 10-yard line.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 10-yard line. Got it and brought down immediately.
Yeah.
It's the ninth play of the drive. And they got him for a loss.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Touchdown, Kentucky!
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
He makes the PAT.
So a 10-play, 78-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
And he's taken down at the 21.
Boy, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out on the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
They're set to go for another round.
Four down. Mike five. Blue 14.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. Here's a handoff up the middle and no room to run. He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down at the 26. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. He's scrambling, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's tackled at about the 37-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. He's on the run, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. From their own 44-yard line, second down. Tries to get out of trouble, but he can't shake the defense. I mean, this is almost getting ridiculous. That is sack number 8.
This guy's going to have to spend a half an hour in the ice tub after this game. It's just been shot after shot all day long. Where's the offensive line?
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. With the pass, incomplete. Robinson, back deep to return. Oh, excellent punt. He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line. These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another 6 on the board here.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Runs right for a nice game. The Volunteers use their second timeout. From their own 31-yard line, third down. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's tackled at the 30-yard line. Tennessee will use their final timeout. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. Got the corner. Williams fields it at the 35. He's knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line. For Kentucky, they're really getting after the quarterback tonight. This defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him.
They also have that one takeaway.
This offense hasn't had any trouble moving the ball on the ground.
No, they haven't. So maybe they should just focus a bit more on the running game to mix it up and keep the defense guessing.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. From their own 49-yard line, it's second down. Zips it to the tight end. Brought down right around the 46-yard line. He's in trouble, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. You can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. You're an offensive coordinator. You love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. From their own 48-yard line. Second down. He's taken down at the 49. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, Kentucky 35, Tennessee 21. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Kentucky came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.